everybody!
Hey! Happy
Welcome
Sunday!
To online Sunday school!
Yay!
Lexi, have you ever played with water during the summer?
I have played with water.
Like, maybe water balloons?
Yeah, or a sprinkler.
Or water guns.
Or the pool.
I was gonna say the pool. That's a good one.
The beach?
Super fun. We don't have one near us, but it's pretty awesome.
It's okay.
So water can be really fun, but it can also be really powerful. Have you ever seen the ocean waves or maybe a river like the Ohio River?
Yeah.
Sometimes, the Ohio River can be really strong.
Yeah, it flows fast, especially in the springtime. It flows super fast.
Yeah. But today in our lesson, we're going to see how God has power over even the strongest rivers and actually all of nature. So let's begin with prayer.
Let's do it.
Dear God, thank you for the opportunity to study your word together. Open our ears to listen and our minds to understand, and bless our lesson today. Amen.
Amen. So, our summer series for Sunday school this summer is called Even the Wind and Waves Obey Him. So we're learning all about how God is more powerful than nature. So last week, if you remember, we learned about first how God led the Israelites in a pillar of
cloud.
Yep, by day. And then by night, he led them in a pillar of
fire.
Fire. So God has power over the clouds and the fire. And then God also split the Red Sea for the Israelites. They crossed on dry ground. That was a miracle. God has power over nature. And he's going to do a similar thing this week. So listen up. We're going to get into it. So after the Israelites crossed the Red Sea, they were in the desert for a really long time. And they got kind of angry. They started complaining to God. They said, "We wish we could just go back to Egypt. In Egypt, we had food and we had rest. And we don't have that here in the desert." And so they complained to God. That was a sin. Do you ever complain to God? I know I do. I complain about maybe the adults in my life or school or maybe doing things that I don't want to do, like chores. I complain a lot, and that's a sin. But God forgives me, and God forgives you too, and God forgave the Israelites as well. So after 40 years, the Israelites were in the desert for 40 years, God led them to the promised land. Now, when they got to the promised land, their leader, Moses, died. And so they had a new leader. God called a new leader, and his name was Joshua. So God told Joshua, "Here's what I want you to do. You're going to cross the Jordan River." And I'm sure Joshua was very confused because it was springtime. The Jordan River was flowing. It was powerful. It was moving, okay? And so God says, "You're going to cross the Jordan River, and here's how you're going to do it. Just how like Moses split the Red Sea, you are going to split the Jordan River by my power." And so what happened was he told the people to line up behind the Ark of the Covenant. What in the world is the Ark of the Covenant? This was the way that God showed his people that he was with them and he was leading them. It was kind of like a big golden box. And that's how the Israelites knew that God was with them. And so the priests carried the Ark of the Covenant, showing that God was leading his people, to the Jordan River. And when they touched the river, the waters split. It stopped flowing so that all the Israelites could pass through. Now, after all the Israelites had passed through, God told Joshua to tell the people to have one person from each of the 12 tribes pick up a big rock from within the river by the Ark of the Covenant and put it in, stack them all up to make a big pile of 12 rocks. That way in the future, when their children and people ask them, "What does that pile of rocks mean? Like, what is that? What does it mean?" They could tell them that God had led his people through the Jordan River and led them into the promised land after 40 years. That's awesome. That's an awesome story. And you know what's awesome about it too is that God still does the same thing for us today. He leads us wherever we go, whether you're home, whether you're at school, whether you're at church, wherever you are, God is always with you and he's always leading you.
Amen.
So let's review our lesson today a little bit, shall we?
We shall.
So Erica.
Yes.
How long, how many years were the Israelites wandering in the desert?
40 years.
40 years. Yeah, they complained to God, and so they had to wander in the desert for 40 years.
That's a long time, Lex.
Yeah.
A long time.
Now, after Moses, who was the new leader? Joshua was the new leader of the Israelites. What river? What was it called? What river did they cross?
That was called the Jordan River.
Yep, they crossed the Jordan River to enter the Promised Land. What was the Ark of the Covenant?
The Ark of the Covenant was a big golden box that God used to remind them that he was leading them.
Exactly. Who carried the Ark?
The priests
carried the Ark. Now, what happened when the priest stepped into the Jordan River?
It split on both sides like the Red Sea did.
Yes, and the Israelites were able to cross through on dry ground. Now, what did 12 men do to remember this great miracle?
They all got one rock, so 12 rocks, and piled them up on the side of the river so it would be a reminder to the people of what God had done for them.
Mm-hmm. How do we know that God is always with us?
God promises that he's with us in the Bible.
Exactly. He promises he's always with us, and so we can trust that he will be. Back to you, Erica.
All right. So today for our craft, we are making the Ark of the Covenant.
Yay!
A 3D version. If you want, you can color yours golden. I did not have a golden crayon, so my apologies. But so here we have the two angels that their wings are touching, as described in the Bible. And then the poles that the priests would use to carry it. So that's super cool.
Mm-hmm.
And it starts off flat on paper like this. Here's all the pieces of it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you cut it out and fold it together, like glue these lines and stick it together like a box. And then it'll end up looking like this. And then you can have your own Ark of the Covenant.
Woo! Little reminder that God is always with you too.
Love it.
Love it.
Let's close with prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for always watching out for us and leading us through this life just like you led the Israelites. Help us never forget that you are always with us and guiding us. Amen.
Amen.
See you next week.
Yeah, we hope you're having a great summer. Only a couple weeks in, but we'll see you next week.
Bye.
Bye.